Praise the Lord, everyone. I thank you for coming out yet again to another book promotion. This promotion is based on my second book, and it's called Strategies of Persecution. Strategies of Persecution. I thank God for the book that Strategies of Persecution has really been a great inspiration to me. Strategies of Persecution comes out of Acts 8. It is the first lesson out of 10 in Acts 8 concerning the deacons and concerning Saul and concerning the persecuting of God's church. Strategies of Persecution is a book that God has given me that has been handed down to my leader, and my leader has given me the assignment for these 10 chapters, these 10 lessons, these 10 volumes. And when she first gave it to me, they were just lessons. But I know that being creative and being who I am, I developed these books, these lessons into books. And there are going to be 10 books. And the first one, the first lesson is Strategies of Persecution. But I'm actually teaching right now in Lesson 6. And Lesson 6 is the identity. But Strategies of Persecution is a book that has been placed in my lap. It's totally different from the teaching. It has a lot more important lessons to go on than the teaching. But I pray that you have an ear to hear on what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Amen. Book 2 will be the front line. So it should be coming out shortly. And I pray that you have an ear to hear. Amen. Excuse my surroundings. There may be a little noise in the background, but please forgive me for that noise. Amen. This lesson that we are in right now is called the Impact Seed. The Impact Seed. And in this lesson called the Impact Seed, we're going to be discussing various issues on the seeds planted. This is actually lesson 4 of 5. Lesson 4 of 5. And you can actually scroll down on my YouTube page and you can get all 4 lessons. Amen. The 5 actions in planting seeds. No matter what kind of seed you plant, there will always be an action. No matter what type of seed you plant, there will always be an action. I believe that many times, if we're not seed-minded, how do we know that that's a seed that's given to us from God? How do we know by not being seed-minded, by not opening up our ears and hearing from God and where God is planting the seed and how He wants the seed to come about? We find that, how can we understand if we're not seed-minded? If we're not able to take a seed and say, look, I know where this came from. I know where it's going. I know where I need to plant it. I need to know, I know what depth, what height, what level that I need to plant this seed, because it's from God. It can be a seed to the mind. It can be a seed to give you intelligence. It can be a seed of wisdom. It can be a seed of an understanding. God works in various ways. And I thank Him because He uses everyone in a unique way. I know that He uses me in a unique way of creative, for being so creative in who I am. Because because I can say that I am very creative in the things that I do in my life. Creative communication. I love to communicate on a creative level. My job as being a teacher or being someone that is in head of a lesson is that my first job is to get you to think. If I can get the listener to think, and then I've done part of my job. If I can get the listener to go back to the drawing board and find out what I was speaking on, then I've done my job. It's part of my job to get the listener to think, to almost have them to say, okay, I know this. I'm not trying to teach anything out of the ordinary, but I'm just trying to get everyone to think on a level to use your mind, use your thoughts, use your God-given gifts, because when we're in warfare, we have to be creative. There's no way around it. You have to be creative in how you think, creative in how you hear, creative in how you see things, creative in how you perceive things. Amen. The five lessons, that has been a very inspiration. Seed-minded. The seed you plant will always have an action or an outlook. There will be an action and there will be an outlook. The action is that whatever you sow reap. The outlook is the what, when, where, and how, and why. There are four outlooks that I want to discuss on the impact seed. That's the what, the when, the where, and the why. The what will be the impact of the seed you plant. The what will be the impact of the seed you plant. The when will have an impact on a specific time. We have to know the right timing in planting seeds. Because I learned that it's very important not to plant seeds in a time where God is not in your heart to plant it. Because seeds, when you plant something and you have a harvest, it would affect everything around you. The where seed will let you know the place of the impact. The where seed will let you know the place of the impact. You see, I can by being seed-minded, I can plant the seed here, and it will have an effect somewhere else. I can plant the seed concerning my household, outside of my household, but then it can have an effect inside my household. The why seed will have an impact on the question. The why seed will have an impact on the question, why am I planting this seed? What am I going to receive from this seed? Am I planting the seed in the right vineyard, and what am I going to receive from it? Am I just going to go about, okay, I just planted the seed and that's it? No. It has to be in a very specific place that you can receive a question from the seed. Amen. The level of the seed you plant will have a result on the height of the platform you stand on. The level of the seed you plant. What level you plant in your seed will have a high impact. It will be an impact on your position. It will be an impact in the place you stand in. It will be an impact on the fatherhood. It will be an impact on the husband. It will be an impact on the son. The level that you are in, the seed you plant in that level will have an impact. The platform you're standing on, the titles that you have, the seeds that you plant, that the titles you have on the positions you have will have an impact every seed you plant is going to have an impact. That's why it's important that we are seed-minded, constantly being seed-minded, constantly planting seeds in the what, when, where, and whys. That will have a special effect in your life. Amen. The platforms you live upon, your title, your ministry, your home, your job, your place of employment, your place of ownership, your household. I wrote in my book Strategies of Persecution and How God Blew the Breath of Life in Man. I found that men live many lives. We have a father who is the teacher of the household. We have the husband who is the provider. We have the son who is the teachable one. We have the co-worker. We have the owner. We have the partner. We have the uncle. We have the grandfather. We have the grandson. We have so many lives. Because God himself blew the breath of life in man. Satan's strategy that I wrote in my book, Strategies of Persecution, his strategy is to disrupt that way of living. If Satan can pull the father out of the household, he pulled the part of the teaching out of the household. If Satan can pull the husband out of the household, he pulled part of the provision in the household, part of the provider in the household. If the enemy can pull the son out of the household, then he's taken the one that is being teached. He's taken the one that is being placed in a position where you can teach him. We have to be very careful, and I wrote in my book, Strategies of Persecution, how we allow Satan to come in with strategies. And I wrote in the back of my book, I wrote that creative warfare is what we're in. Satan may use strategies on his end, but God gives us strategies of our own, and it's called creative warfare. Amen. Let's move on in this impact seed. Most of the time, you sear the seeds you plant. You are searing seeds you plant most of the time. Some people might say you're planting seeds in someone's ministry. But I say, yes, you're right. You're planting seeds in someone's ministry. But you're also sharing your seeds. And what I mean by sharing your seeds, you're sharing a seed into someone else, into their ministry. Because when you share something, there's going to be a purposed effect on where you're sharing it, who you're sharing it to. And there's also going to be a purposed effect because you shared it. So there are two actions that's going to take place on both ends. And I find that very important. That's why I'm always sowing into a ministry. I'm always sharing my seeds. I'm always sharing my seeds into someone's ministry. Because there's going to be a purposed effect on their end and also on my end. Amen. No matter what or when or where or why the seed is being seen in and around your life, there will be an overflow. You see, when you continue to plant seeds and plant them and plant them and plant them and plant them in different vineyards, different places, different people, different times, you're going to receive an overflow, an overflow of harvest. There is a constant overflow that's going to come your way. It's like a waters brook experience. And I explained that in the last lesson I spoke on. It's called the front line. A waters brook experience is a waters brook A water brook is not a river. A water brook is created by something that comes from above. A water brook is created by a flow of rain that may hit an elevated place like a mountain or a hill. And the water comes down from the mountain and it creates a pathway. And that pathway, it creates of many things. And David found three small stones on the water brook. David found these stones that was created by the water brook. David found the three small stones that was created from the pathway that was created from the water brook. I thank God for just being seed-minded. By understanding, I want you to think on what I'm saying. Go back and do some research. And maybe you can pull out different areas, different vineyards on what I'm speaking on. Amen. Seeds can have an impact on your life. A seed can have an impact on your spiritual life, on your Christian life, on your walk with God. In every area, being seed-minded is very important. You can build a house just with one seed. There is a foundation seed and there are pillar seeds. And what I mean by a foundation seed, I mean that you are in the process of building a home, so there has to be a foundation if you're building it from the ground up. There are seeds you need to plant in the foundation first. There are seeds in getting the paperwork right. There are seeds in getting the money right. There are seeds in getting the contractors right. There are seeds in developing the material, getting the right things you need, the right things you need. See, these are all seeds that you're planting into the foundation. And when you plant them into the foundation, there's going to be an overflow of harvest. The building is going to be constructed and everything is going to come into order. And that is what I mean by seed, the foundation seeds. We have to be very creative in what we say and how we think. Because I know that God is a creative being. He is the master of creation. He created the heavens and the earth. He was creative in how he created the heaven and the earth. You can step outside your house right now and just look and see how creative God was and still is. Amen. Let's move on here. Only the seed can be planted in the right vineyard. It will yield fruit. Plant your seeds in the right vineyard. Be seed-minded first. Because I believe that God will also give us unctions and where we need to plant our seeds. And how we need to plant, how much we need to plant. And by being obedient, there will be a harvest. Let's take our Leviticus 21 through 5. Leviticus 21 through 5. God said unto Moses, no one is to give Molech any seeds, any one of the children of Israel, or any strangers living with them. The Bible says that they will be stoned and put to death. God said unto Moses, no one of the children of Israel, or the strangers that are living in their households, or that are living around them, plant seeds into witchcraft. Plant seeds into a king that was practicing witchcraft. We have to be very careful where we plant our seeds. Because we can plant the seed into something God doesn't want us to plant in. And it will have an effect on our lives, and it can set us back years. I learned that a long time ago, the counterfeit will always come before a real thing. Most of the time, in my life, I've seen counterfeits that always came before the real thing. There was times when I fell into the counterfeits, and it set back years of my life. There was times where I seen the counterfeit, and I avoided it. We have to be very careful, saints of God, because the enemy uses strategies against us. That is why we have to be creative in our warfare and understand and hear from God. The what, when, the where, and the why. Witchcraft. The what impact would have given the king strength over the people. It will create something. And I pray that you have an understanding ear to hear. Please, my books are now on Amazon. Strategies of Persecution and Mighty Men of Valor. And pretty soon the front line will be out. Take a copy. Let me know what you think. Email me. Write me. My address is in my address isn't in my books. Send me a message, anything. Let me know what you got out of the book. Tell me something. Teach me something that you received out of the book. Amen. God bless.